Hi everyone, welcome to the first video on the Graphometric Analysis Lab. Let me first discuss the goal of the lab. First, you'll be learning a few experimental techniques in this lab, carrying out a precipitation reaction, filtration, and heating with crucibles. A second goal is to understand how the concept of percent composition can be used to determine the identity of an unknown. The term graphometric analysis literally means analysis using weights. So in this case, what we're trying to do is determine the identity of an unknown by measuring masses of substances. Graphometric analysis can be done on any type of chemical reaction. In today's lab, we will specifically carry this analysis out on a precipitation reaction, which is a reaction that produces a solid product. This picture shows an example of a precipitation reaction. When you mix one reactant with the other one, you immediately see what looks like a yellow cloud appearing. The cloudy substance blocks your view, so that is a sign that it is a solid. If you wait for some time, the solid will eventually settle to the bottom of the beaker, forming a sediment, or more commonly called a precipitate. Often the sedimented solid can be collected using a technique called decantation, which is used to separate the clear solution away from the precipitate. The precipitation reaction you will carry out today is a reaction between an unknown sulfate salt, which we give the formula MXSO4, and barium chloride, BaCl2. One of the products in this reaction is barium sulfate, which is a precipitate, and a chloride salt, which is aqueous, or soluble. Our goal is to collect and measure the mass of the barium sulfate, and using that and the mass of the unknown sulfate salt, we'll be able to determine the identity of the metal M cation in the unknown salt. Note that for this idea to work, we must carry out the reaction with the unknown sulfate salt being the limiting reactant. This condition ensures that all the sulfate in the unknown will be converted to the barium sulfate. To determine the identity of the metal cation M, we will use the two definitions of percent composition. One way to calculate percent composition of an element in a compound is by taking the molar mass of the element and multiply it by the number of moles of the element in the compound, and then dividing the result by the molar mass of the entire compound. I call this the theoretical definition because it can be calculated without doing any measurement. You just need the chemical formula of the compound and the molar masses of the elements from the periodic table. There's a second way to calculate percent composition, which I call the experimental definition. Here, you use the actual mass of an element that you measure divided by the mass of the compound. Note the difference between mass and molar mass in the previous definition, which doesn't need to be measured. Now, I will show you how you use these two definitions to help us determine the identity of the metal cation M in our unknown sulfate salt using this example. Here, we measure 0.323 grams of the unknown sulfate salt and react it to form 0.433 grams of a precipitate. Remember that the precipitate is our barium sulfate, as the equation above shows. You may wonder about the other pieces of information given here, the 50 milliliter of water and the 6 molar HCl. Both of these are experimental conditions that don't affect our calculation. To determine the identity of the cation, we just need the two masses. First, we must determine the mass of sulfate in our unknown sulfate. Because we assume that all the sulfate is converted to barium sulfate, the mass of sulfate in the unknown sulfate is also equal to the mass of sulfate in barium sulfate. The mass of sulfate in barium sulfate we can calculate by multiplying the percent composition of sulfate in barium sulfate and the mass of the barium sulfate. The percent composition of sulfate in barium sulfate is just the molar mass of sulfate, 96.06 grams per mole, divided by the molar mass of the barium sulfate, which is 233.38 grams per mole, times the mass of barium sulfate, which is 0.433 grams. This gives us the following answer, with the third digit bolded to keep track of significant figures. Once we have this number, we can now calculate the percent composition of sulfate in our unknown compound by using the experimental definition of percent composition, which means we're going to need to divide the mass of sulfate by the mass of the unknown compound. When we do this, we get 55.17779%. This number is useful because this is the same exact percentage that we get if we use the theoretical definition of percent composition, which is the molar mass of sulfate divided by the molar mass of the unknown compound. As you can see, if we know the percentage and we know the molar mass of sulfate, we can solve for the molar mass of the compound. If we rearrange that equation, we get the molar mass of the compound being 174.091778 grams per mole. From there, we can subtract out the sulfate to get the molar mass of just the cations, which is 78.031778 grams per mole. Now, to determine which cation we have, we need to use both the molar mass and the charge of the cation. There are three possible cations that we can have, plus 1, plus 2, and plus 3. The formula of the sulfate with each of these types of cations is shown here. If we have a plus 1 cation, then we have 2 moles of our cation. So the correct molar mass must be half of the number that we get. In other words, it's 39.0 grams per mole. If we have a plus 2 cation, the molar mass would just be the number that we get, which is 78.0 grams per mole. If we try to use a plus 3 cation, it won't work in this case because the total molar mass we have is too small to account for all that elements in there. So the only options are either a plus 1 or plus 2 in this particular example. Now, if we go to the periodic table, we find that potassium ion has a molar mass of 39.1 grams per mole, and it is also a group 1 cation. So it must be the answer that we're looking for. To confirm, if we try to find an element with molar mass of 78.0 grams per mole, the closest is selenium, but selenium is an anion, not a cation, so it wouldn't make sense as an answer to this problem. So that's how you use the concept of percent composition and mass data to determine the identity of your unknown cation. In the next video, I will go through the experimental steps that you must perform for a successful reaction.